Right, so that can become a little bit confusing because we have seen that we can have forced regression, we can have normal regression, and to really truly understand sequence stratigraphy, we need to take a step back. So let's forget about our little model for a minute. Let's forget about the LST, and let's look at some fundamental control on sequence stratigraphy. Let's look under the hood at the processes, the geological processes, and what really matters for sequence stratigraphic responses. So on this diagram, you have an idealized transgression-regression cycle. The red curve at the top, that's the base level change, and you can see we have a base level rise, so that's when the values goes to more positive, followed by a base level fall, and then followed by another base level rise. Now that's an idealized curve, it's a harmonic curve. Not every base level rise and fall is like this, but this is the simplest thing you can have, the simplest curve you can have. And interestingly, if you look at the transgression regression curve, that's the dashed purple line here, that curve is not harmonic, it's not symmetrical in the same way that the red curve is. So in other words, the response of the sediment is not at all completely similar to the forcing mechanism, which is the base level change. And the key to understanding this is really looking at the rates of the different processes, because in sequence stratigraphy and in sedimentology, rates play a major role in controlling what happens and in controlling the architecture of the sedimentary deposits. So let's look at this diagram again, but this time let's focus on rates. So at the bottom here, you have the rates of the different things happening. And the rates essentially represents the rates of base level change. So that's the base level curve. And the rates of sedimentation. That's the green area here. So for simplicity in this model, the sedimentation rates are maintained constant. So you just have one sedimentation rate represented by the top of this green line. The rates of base level change you obtain by looking at the slope of the base level curve at the top. Now that slope, you can calculate the rates by essentially doing a derivative of that curve. And you can see that actually, even though it's a simple curve, the slope of that curve changes. And that's why the rates of base level change are also not constant. And that has important implication because what we need to do now is look at those rates with respect to the rates of sedimentation. Because remember your accommodation equation, the rates of sedimentation play a major role in this accommodation equation. So the rates of sedimentation are constant and they're positive. They never really change. Again, it's not necessarily realistic, but that's the way it is. But the rates of base level change are actually changing. Now, when the rates of base level change are above zero, that means you are creating space, you're creating accommodation for the sediments. When the rates are below zero, it means effectively you are eroding, you're removing space, so you're not creating any space. Now, if the rate of accommodation creation, so the rate of base level change, are above the rates of sedimentation, you have a transgression. That's the blue area here. We have two areas on this curve where we have a transgression. And that's very easy to understand. It's that if you're creating more space than you can fill with the sediment, so the rates of sediment being lower than the rate of accommodation creation, by definition, you will have a transgression. You will have a movement of the shoreline back onto the continent. And that's because, of course, we create more space than we can fill. Now, there is an instance, of course, where the rate of accommodation creation, they are still positive, you still create accommodation, but the amount of accommodation that you create is not as high as the amount of sediment that you bring into the system. So in other words, here we have three cases where the rate of accommodation creation are equal or lower to the rates of sedimentation. When that happens, it means that you're still rising base level, so you're still creating space, but you're filling that space faster than you're creating it. So by definition, when this happens, you have a normal regression. That's these three arrows here, and they are representative of normal regression. So you don't have any erosion, you don't have a base level lowering, but you have progradation of your system into the basin because you are filling the sedimentation, the space with sediments faster than you're creating the space. And then of course, there's the case where the rate of base level change are negative. In other words, now we are really having a base level fall. And when that happens, then by definition, you cannot accumulate sediments and you have a forced regression. So you can see how important understanding rates of processes can be for sequence stratigraphy and how the control of the relative rate of sedimentation versus the rate of accommodation creation plays a massive role in controlling these different things. So again, when the rate of accommodation change are above the rate of sedimentation, we have a transgression. When the rate of base level change are positive and equal or lower than the rate of sedimentation, we have normal regressions. And when those rates of base level change are negative, we have forced regression. And that explains why this purple curve is not symmetrical and is not similar to the red curve, the base level change curve. It's because of the relative rate of sedimentation and the rates of base level change. We start with transgression when we have the rates higher than the rates of sedimentation, followed by a normal regression, a forced regression. And then as we go towards the low stand, what's interesting is we have another normal regression before finally those rates are positive and are above the rates of sedimentation, in which case we have a transgression. And of course that cycle continues. So that's, I think, is very interesting because I've showed you the most simplistic example of a sea level curve. It's a harmonic, very simple, very boring, symmetrical curve. And yet the response is non-linear, meaning that it's not a simple, you know, one forcing gives you one particular response. And it's especially true because the rates of sedimentation in nature are rarely or never constant. So you can see how complex the response of the sequences, the stacking pattern, can be. So that's maybe a word of caution about when you apply sequence stratigraphy to a particular basin.